Hi, welcome everyone. Today we're very pleased to have Julie from GT Immigration Services. Could you please tell us a bit more about you and your background in Australia?
Yeah, so I arrived in Australia about 9 years ago. I was working in HR at that time after I became a citizen. 4 years ago, I was like, well, I need to change my career, change something. So I went back to study immigration law and became an immigration agent 3 years ago.
You know, as a international professional wants to come to Australia or even maybe to study in Australia or invest in Australia, why should you engage an immigration agent?
As maybe people heard, like, we had the massive changes in legislation about 2 weeks ago. And that can happen at any time. So the conditions are quite restrictive and they can change again at any time. So if you want to make sure of the path you want to take, are you eligible and do you tick the boxes to get a visa, it's always good to go and see a professional because we are aware of all those conditions, all the changes, because we've been, you know, we had the accreditation, because we had the diploma in this, so we kind of understand how the law works. And maybe it's something, it's quite difficult to understand, so that maybe a professional can explain that to you.
So in terms of cost, can you give us maybe a bit of an idea on how an immigration agent work?
You have temporary visa and permanent visa. Permanent visa, of course, include a lot of more of paperwork and information you need to provide, and therefore usually migration agent will give you a price regarding the type of visa you're asking. If it's a temporary visa, usually it's cheaper, but a student visa, for example, is $500. So the visa itself is not really expensive, but then what can be costly is the cost of study. And if you made a mistake with your application, you can end up of not being reimbursed for your visa, and depends on the agreement with your school or university, but end up maybe not being able to get reimbursed for all your fees. So it can be really costly for even for a student visa. And then for 457 visa, the cost itself of the visa is not really expensive and can be reimbursed if there is a mistake and you want to withdraw your application before. But if you made a mistake in your application and this one is refused, you will never get reimbursed, never. So it's really important to make sure that your application is in line with what they're requesting.
One of the key benefits of having an immigration agent, or I mean, for me who's been in Australia for almost 10 years, came on a 457 visa that was done through an immigration agent. Then at the working holiday visa, I did it myself. Then I had another 457 visa, which was done by an immigration agent. Then I went through a skills assessment through an immigration agent, and then applied for my PR with my previous employer, and that was done through an immigration agent. I didn't use an immigration agent for citizenship, but yeah, from my experience, it's good. I mean, to have someone to guide you as well, because you feel a bit, again, you know, alone against the system.
Well, that's why at least with migration agent, we know exactly what you should do or not do.
Maybe just to recap, why we would advise you as, you know, migrants in the country to engage immigration agents such as Julie would be the comfort, pick the right visa.
And make sure that, you know, the criteria that are requesting for immigration, that you're meeting those criteria. You're not doing a visa that you're not eligible for.
Over the medium or long term, actually save money by, you know, maybe waiting a bit less. Make sure you don't pay a visa that you'll never get. You know, potentially get templates, recommendations to speed up the process as well. Thank you for your time, Julie.
Thank you.